You will not have wealth. You will not be rich. But you will have respect. And will always be a soldier of this great army. Now, these are the lines spoken by Field Marshal Sam Manekshaw, a man who took 9 bullets for this country. He battled for victories, but was belittled for respect. Even in his last hours, the nation didn't pay back, didn't honor his services. But what he's left behind is an ideology for soldiers. Every Indian warrior, even to this day, is ready to give up his life, give up his soul, so that the Indian tricolor flutters with pride. In its pride, he finds his honor. But what do we give back to them? Whenever there's a crisis, we turn to the army. Whenever there's a problem, we turn to the army. But when it's our turn, we turn to silence. I'm talking about one rank, one pension.
Tracing from 1973, ORoP, short for One Rank, One Pension, has been a lingering battle for the ex-servicemen of the Indian Armed Forces, which continues even today.
One Rank, One Pension, as passed by the Parliament, is as under.
For those retiring at the same rank,
if they have completed the same amount of service,
will get the same pension
irrespective of the date of retirement,
and it will be in perpetuity.
That's it.
In other words, it means when persons from the armed forces have a particular rank and have served for the same time, they should get the same amount of pension regardless of whenever they retire. ORoP was removed in 1973, with the pension rates for the armed forces being reduced from 70% to 50% of their last pay drawn, following which salaries and pensions rose with each pay commission. For instance, a colonel retiring in 1990 will receive way lesser pension than a colonel retiring in 2015, even though they worked for the same number of years. This also leads to a situation where a senior officer retiring in 1990 gets a lesser pension than a junior officer retiring in 2015. These disparities therefore lie across all ranks in the armed forces, resulting in a rather inequitable pension model. Although ORoP is a long-standing due since 1973, it only came to the forefront when the then Prime Ministerial candidate Narendra Modi promised it as one of the first agenda in a rally for ex-servicemen at Rewari, Haryana in 2013. This announcement immediately won him a support of a majority of 2.8 million veterans in the country.
वन रैंक वन पेंशन वाली समस्या उलझती नहीं मित्रों, मिल बैठ करके रास्ता निकालते और हमारे पूर्व सैनिकों को, सेना में बैठे हमारे जवानों को एक सम्मान और गौरव के साथ जीने का अवसर देता.
द पार्टी ट्रायंफ बट द प्रॉमिसेस डिड. द इनजस्टिस व्हिच बिगन इन 1973 गेव राइज टू अ रेवोल्यूशन व्हिच वाज सिमरिंग अंटिल नाउ.
और दो लड़ाई लड़की आठवां पाकिस्तान की 65 और 71 और रजेब खंडा करके आज मेरे को 3500 रुपया पेंशन दी.
महंगाई तो बहुत बढ़ चुकी है, आज का दूध ही ले लो 50 रुपये किलो दूध है, क्या करेगा. चलो 1500 रुपये तो 2 किलो भी ले दो 3000 तो दूध का चला गया.
गुजारा कहाँ से होएगा? उसका बच्चा जितनी तो फीस हो जाती है, अगर एक बच्चे को स्कूल में पढ़ाए तो उसकी इतनी फीस हो जाती है बेटा, अच्छे स्कूल में पढ़ाओ, इससे बच्चा पढ़ भी नहीं पाते और घर का गुजारा भी नहीं होता।
Most of the jawans of the armed forces retire at an early age of 35, stopping their career at the prime of their lives. Thus begins the battle for survival, which took form as ORoP.
What are the defense services asking for, the veterans asking for? What they're asking for is one rank, one pension is a compensation, not just for a job which they think is tougher than what the civilian counterparts do, but also a compensation for their early retirement.
Go to the villages. Talk to some Johnny over there. You know, barring a Savdhan and a Vishram, and haan sir, ji janab, uske alawa usko kuch nahi aata hai. Wo kya karega bahar jaake? Because from the age of 15, he's only fought for the nation. Yeah. Did nothing. He had no family life, nothing, kuch bhi nahi tha. Ab, at the age of 35, if you just leave him high and dry, what will he do with his life? At 35, you make a guy redundant. You know what you've done? You've killed his soul. What will he do?
You killed his soul. So what will he do? And he's not just alone. There are 26 lakhs just like him who sacrificed their lives for this nation. They had their choices. Just like us. But their first choice was and always will be the nation. Now think of those 6.5 lakh widows whose men sacrificed their lives for this nation. ये लड़ाई है ORoP की। क्या ये लड़ाई सिर्फ उन सैनिकों की है? क्या वो सैनिक हमारे नहीं? हमारे इस देश के नहीं?
There are no demands. These are our dues. ORoP is for services already rendered. We've already done this. So therefore, it is our back wages. So there are no demands. It is our dues.
2000 इच्छा भी नहीं तो इसे मेरी पेंशन ना 1000 थी 1000 पेंशन ली थी और बुढ़ापा की भी ना देते तो ये कहते हैं कि इतनी है मिल जाएगी 10 साल नौकरी कर आया और उड़ाता तो नाम कटा के आ गया था.
The protectors of the flag became protesters of the street. Havaldar Singh and a few others vowed a fast unto death on 15 June 2015 with the hope that their feeble voices will be heard by some.
15 June se lekar aur 15 August tak hum 24 ghante ke liye baithte rahe aur 15 August ko jab hamare favor mein pradhanmantri ne koi baat nahi bola to hum 16 August ko maranant par baith gaye the main aur Karan Pushpinder sahab. और 10 दिन के बाद हमारी हालत ख़राब होने लगी और हमको बोला गया कि आप हॉस्पिटल चलो, लेकिन हमने ये बोल दिया कि मरना इसका मतलब बताओ क्या है, हम हॉस्पिटल नहीं जाएंगे, हम तो इधर ही मरेंगे मंच पर.
एवरी एक्स सर्विसमैन मे वांट अ लॉट मोर देन व्हाट द गवर्नमेंट इज गिविंग, बट आई थिंक इट्स इम्पेरेटिव टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट द गवर्नमेंट हैज लिमिटेशंस टू प्रोक्योर अ फंड ऑफ 8,000 crores एंड टू वर्क विद द फाइनेंस मिनिस्ट्री एंड द डिफेंस मिनिस्ट्री इन इट सेल्फ इज अ हर्क्यूलन टास्क. Having said that, it has been a priority to applaud all those servicemen that have worked for the country, but there are limitations of the government.
I think this argument that the country can't afford it is absolute nonsense. You know, we've just added a Swachh Bharat cess of 0.5% in service tax. I think if there is a will, a way can certainly be found.
Another aspect that I want to highlight on the economic point of view is that this year, the government of India and the finance ministry, out of the total budget that was allocated to the defense ministry, got back in 13%, that's around 29,000 crores, which means the defense ministry was only able to spend 87% of its budget. So if you have returned 29,000 crores, which is a big question mark that you've not spent enough on material, ammunition, on technology, on weapons, but if you're returning 29,000 crores, why can't you just find 8,300 crores from that 29,000 crores and provided to the veterans for this year.
Currently, we are all still in the dark about how much this is going to cost. And the other point that I'd also like to make is, for all you know, if the pension burden becomes very high, we may restrict future pay commissions from giving pay increases. Because how do you curtail pension expenditure, right? If you have a wage-indexed pension, then if the wage doesn't grow by very much, the pension is not going to grow by that very much too, right? So tomorrow, going forward, there is going to be the issue of what are we going to see in terms of pay commission rises. And maybe that's where we will see a problem in the coming years.
The point that military personnel put their lives on the line, unlike others like us, is valid. It is true. But it has nothing to do with pensions. It has to do with their payment, which they get while they're serving. And if you increase that, they will automatically get a higher pension. Why do you have to tinker with the pension system, which concerns those who have retired or are retiring?
We're talking about one rank, one pension. I'm saying don't give me one rank, one pension here. You let me serve till the age of 60, no? They're not letting me do that as well. Because you don't want a pot-bellied guy sitting on the border protecting you. You need to put that entire thing in the perspective. Aap ye bhi nahi dete ho, wo bhi nahi dete ho. Chahte kya ho fir aap humse? Aur jab crisis ka time aata hai, you get the armed forces. What motivation will I will be left with, you know?
The hunger strike went on for days, bringing in new support from the ex-soldiers throughout the nation. Their muted voices were finally addressed on the 11th of August, 2015.
Prime Minister aspirant Narendra Modi, in a rally to our ex-servicemen, promised in unambiguous terms that he would provide one rank, one pension. Personally, I believe they should have done the economic study before making that promise. But having made that promise as the Prime Minister aspirant at that time and now the Prime Minister of the country, I would imagine that he would feel duty-bound to implement it in all respects. And it's a little curmudgeonly to now start quibbling about, you know, costs and so on. All of that should have been done before making the promise. So it's a political issue that has now become an economic issue.
The government has taken a decision to implement the OROP.
Finally, on the 5th of September 2015, the government announced OROP for ex-servicemen with an exclusion for personnel retiring prematurely among various other clauses, leaving the ex-servicemen dissatisfied.
लेकिन 5 सितंबर को हमको ये बताया गया कि आपका जो वन रैंक वन पेंशन है आपको लागू किया गया, आप उठ जाओ। लेकिन बीच में बीआरसी का वो फंदा उड़ा दिया था, लेकिन हम नहीं उठे। तब हमारा धोखा दे के हमको ये हमारा फर्स्ट तुलाया गया। लेकिन फर्स्ट तुलाने के बाद हमको बोला गया कि 24-25 दिन में आपका हम वन रैंक वन पेंशन का लेटर दे देंगे।
But you must understand, the fact of the matter is that everybody is not fighting for that stupid, you know, 1,000, 3,000, 4,000 out here. You can't degrade a soldier, you know, to a limit wherein he starts begging and he comes onto the street. Yeah. You please do the statistics analysis of any country and show me one country, whether it is as minuscule country as Nepal or Bhutan, wherein soldiers have come down to the street begging for their own rights. None. You'll not find anybody. The governments come and the governments go. Believe you me, it's the bureaucracy which is running the country. The fight is not with the government. The fight is with the system.
The promise was fulfilled, but it was an impaired one. ORoP was awarded, but rather than healing the wounds of the warriors, inflicted them with fresh ones. Jantar Mantar echoed with the chants for justice.
One rank, one pension!
For Izzat, for their dignity, but the echoes could never resonate in the air of the Rashtrapati Bhavan. Letters marked with blood were sent to the president. Medals of honor and awards of gallantry were returned to the state. But it all were, perhaps in vain. The former soldiers' determination were put to test once again. 20th November 2015, a day which marks a milestone in the journey of ORoP, a turning point for the fight for respect. The government recommends ORoP for all central government employees in its 7th pay commission report. ORoP, earlier a scheme designed for the armed forces by its parent committee, the Koshyari Committee, was now, in the words of the veterans, degraded, destroyed, diluted, and open to all.
Are you doing this? वन सर्विस को दे दिया तो ये क्या मतलब हुआ? आपने यहाँ प्रसाद बांटा, यहाँ भी दे दो। जो सरकार ने नोटिफिकेशन शुरू किया मंजूर नहीं है। उसमें 7 खामियां हैं, गलतियां हैं, सीरियस गलतियां हैं। अगर उसे लागू करते हैं तो वो वन रैंक वन पेंशन होगा ही नहीं।
The ORP announced was not the ORP which was promised. The veterans found it diluted. According to the veterans, the announced ORP had 7 major anomalies. The government notice says that pensions will be calculated as an average of pay scale of given ranks according to the base year agreed upon, which will greatly reduce pensions. The financial year is considered while dealing with matters concerning finance. However, as per the government notification, ORP has been issued to be calculated according to the calendar year. The Parliament had sanctioned ORP to be calculated from 1st April 2014, but the government notice said it would be calculated from 1st July 2014. This will lead to a loss of 3 months of increased pensions. Progressive increase in pensions every year will only be revised and equalized every 5 years. According to the veterans, the committee should have 3 veteran members. One person currently serving in the armed forces and one more member which the government can retain. The concept of ORP should be executed in perpetuity. The Central Pay Commissions should be kept away from ORP and should not have the power to adjudicate it but only to integrate ORP.
The current defense minister has said, this pension I am declaring it as military pension. That is how it is going to be different from rest of the pension in entire country. All that thing is all gone down the drain. I mean, the bureaucracies, it's like tsunami of bureaucracies, even kind of suck them also. Yeah.
The army does not seem to be prepared to, accept a new pension scheme. The public seems to have great sympathy for the army. And it's a matter of public opinion. If public opinion wants us to pay the army a guaranteed pension, we can do so, but then someone's going to have to pay the taxes or someone's going to have to do without public services. If you have this special case that you may want to make for the armed forces, then it has to be understood that since the armed forces are government employees, we cannot treat them differently from other government employees permanently. We already are.
Look, I think you get the government you deserve and you get the army that you deserve. If you're not willing to pay for security, then don't expect the army to be more professional. Are we willing to let the armed forces go the same way as the police or as other forms of government? If the answer is no, then I think we should be willing to pay for it.
So ORP has been sanctioned, stamped and sealed. It stands alive, but its soul ripped apart. A standard blanket ORP for all central government employees, is that justified? Is that how much a soldier's life is worth?
Wrinkled by the tides of time, they're still waiting with hope in their eyes. Waiting, patiently, that someday the country will pay heed to those lost lives.
और मैंने बेरा कोनी मान पढ़ हूँ अनपढ़ इसे मेरे लड़के हैं 10-10 पढ़ रहे हैं हमने क्या का बेरा कोई
किस्मत कैसी है अच्छी किस्मत है मेरे लई दिन रहने की मेरी कैसी
The decision has raised more questions than it has answered. However, the question arises for the forces, what next?
कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन के अंदर हमें प्रोटेस्ट के जो भी अलाउड साधन हैं हम उन सभी साधनों को जुटाएंगे और सरकार से वन रैंक वन पेंशन असली वाली लेने के लिए मांग करेंगे
देश का नुकसान तो हम करेंगे नहीं क्योंकि हम ये इसमें क्या कानून में रहने वाले हैं हमने 16 साल नौकरी किया है हमने कानून में रह कर ही नौकरी किया है लेकिन कानून के दायरे में ही हम रहते हैं अभी भी कानून के दायरे में ही रहते हैं लेकिन अगर इन्होंने ना किया तो हमको अपने आप को हम कांगनी पेंट जरूर करेंगे
ORP however does not end here the future of one rank one pension also decides the future of the armed forces profession not only are the feelings of the ex servicemen played with but also the morale the motivation and the patriotism of the youth
in fact if you ask me this nation is treating armed forces as a stepchild which is very very incorrect that feeling has to be removed And the nation has to come up and take some extra steps to remove that feeling. Otherwise, I can guarantee you and I can tell you with full authority that in coming 10 to 15 years, you will have armed forces which will not be ready to fight.
Soldier protects what? Guards whom? A piece of barren land? No. The soldier protects each inch of the country and also protects its countrymen for what? For the love of its country. For the love, he puts everything on stake, even at the peril of his life. He protects the integrity and sovereignty of the nation. Therefore, respect your soldier.
We let them fight for us. We let them lose their lives. And now we leave them on the streets. Is that justified? Is this the future we're showing the nation? Is this the tomorrow we want? It's time to think. It's time to rise.
तिरंगा था नाम मेरा, माटी थी पहचान मेरी, मातृभूमि की फिजा में लहराती धीमी सी महक मेरी, कहलाता रखवाला अब निरस्त्र सी याद मेरी, इतिहास के पन्नों में बस खून की स्याही मेरी, स्वाभिमान और शौर्य कहा हस्ती ही मेरी ना रही, देश को मैं याद नहीं, मेरी कोई पहचान नहीं।